Now that we've set up a range of analytics, from expression analyses to roll-up analyses to event frame generation analyses, let's take a look at how to manage all of them. I'm here on the Management tab in PI System Explorer, and I can see that I have a list of all of my different analyses that are running at the moment. Here I'm able to set up a number of different operations, including backfilling, recalculating, as well as enabling specific analyses for automatic recalculation. Automatic recalculation is a new feature of AF 2017 R2, so you'll need to upgrade if you don't see this option available on your system. Automatic recalculation needs to be enabled globally, and then each individual analysis that you would like to set up automatic recalculation for can be set here. You also have the option to individually backfill or recalculate these analyses, and that can be achieved by right-clicking on the specific analysis on the Analysis tab, which I'll show later as well. I have a number of options if I want to do these bulk analysis recalculations. I can click at the top to check all of my analyses, and then I have my different operations on the right, where I can choose to either start or stop all of these analyses, enable them for automatic recalculation, disable for recalculation, or backfill or recalculate them. The difference between backfilling and recalculating, if there's no history or data present in these analyses, then backfill and recalculate essentially do the same thing. However, if there is a history of data recorded for individual analyses, backfilling will allow you to fill in any gaps, whereas recalculating will wipe out all of the data that's there and will recalculate the expression. For ease of management, we're also able to perform analysis searches. That way, we're only operating on the analyses that we wish to change. I'm going to search by the template in order to find the downtime severity analyses that we created earlier. Now I've found all of my downtime severity analyses, and these are the ones that create my event frames based on the different types of downtime events. I can select all of them, and I'm going to backfill these analyses for a week. In this particular case, with event frames, I'll always need to perform a recalculation, so this will wipe out any existing event frames. And I can queue this up. I'll get a few progress bars and a check mark when it's complete. To confirm that we have successfully backfilled, I'll take a look at the Event Frames tab and see if event frames were generated for these different wells and if they had different downtime severities. Over the last week, it looks like I've had a few downtime events for well 29. My other wells do not indicate downtime events. This is manually entered data, and I've only manually entered data for this well 29, so I expect these results. We can see based on the name, the different types of severity events. This is using the percent at attribute percent substitution parameter in my event frame naming conventions. Let's go back to the Management tab and see how we can set this up for automatic recalculation on another analysis. Automatic recalculation was added to AF 2017 R2, and again, you will need to enable this individually on each analysis, as well as selecting the global parameter to allow any automatic recalculations to occur. Automatic recalculations have a wide number of use cases. In particular, one that comes to mind is if you have manually entered data. If you have data that is arriving late frequently, then having automatic recalculation on an analysis that depends on this data makes sense to opt in for. If my power consumption numbers are frequently brought in late, I might want to opt in for recalculation. And I can just click on the Enable Automatic Recalculation for selected analyses and click Enable. You'll notice the symbol now appears, showing that it is enabled for automatic recalculation. To wrap up, I'll just show you how to backfill an analysis on an individual basis on the Elements tab. We can select one of our analyses that we have here, right-click, and choose Backfill or Recalculate. Again, if we'd like to backfill, we'll be leaving in the existing data and filling in any gaps. And if we want to recalculate, we'll be permanently deleting the existing data and doing a recalculation of the expression analysis. I'll set my time field for 1 day ago, and I can hit start. And when it's complete, I'll get a check mark.